Howdy. So today I haven't vlogged anything. It was a just a family day kind of thing. One of the things that happened today, I feel like I've been waiting for about 14 years, and I just didn't know it. I saw Lincoln. Okay, I've loved Abraham Lincoln probably since I was about 10 years old. I had gotten a book because I was so obsessed with them, and I was 11 because it was the night I broke my ankle, I was reading it. So I was 11, so I already had the obsession for a while. So I'm thinking I was about 10. And Daniel Day-Lewis's portrayal of Lincoln was exactly how I would picture Abraham Lincoln. And I thought I was gonna cry through the whole movie. I didn't. I teared up a few times. It was just glorious. There were a few people in it that I didn't expect to be, like Joseph Gordon-Levitt and John Hawkes. I didn't expect them to be in it. And I was like, oh, hey. Oh my God, I just loved his quiet confidence and how strong he was. That's the way that you hope Abraham Lincoln was, you know? That's, I don't know. If you've seen the movie, I think you understand. I was just a huge fan of Abraham Lincoln. I blame Abraham Lincoln for my top hat obsession. And I don't know, I find him oddly attractive, and Daniel Day-Lewis was hot as Lincoln. Oh my gosh. I'm kind of swooning a little bit because I just loved it. Oh, I wore my penny necklace too, and I didn't even realize it till halfway through the movie. I was like, it's just crazy, and it makes you wonder, you know, which side you would have been on. Obviously, right now, the thought of having slaves and treating people like property is not even. I can't imagine that, you know, like, I can't imagine that, you know, if rights were taken away from people, I know that I would fight for them, whether it be women's rights to vote or black people's rights to vote or whatever, what have you, I don't know, different religions' rights to vote, you know, I would fight for them, and I know that beyond a shadow of a doubt, but it's like, okay, that's based on now. At the same time, I think that a lot of it's nature versus nurture, you know, but I think a lot of it's on the nature side. You're born a certain way. It just makes you wonder if it were back in the day who you would be. You hope you would be on the side that you're on today, but like you don't know, you know? And I just, all the people who had to fight for like basic rights, and it's things that we take for granted today. Women, minorities voting, they choose now not to. And it wasn't that long ago that we didn't have the right. We weren't allowed, you know, and if that were taken away from us, we would fight tooth and nail whether you voted in the last election. They say you can't in the next one, you're gonna flip out, you know, and that's, I don't know, I think that's something that's really important to remember because it seems like these things took place so long ago and that Abraham Lincoln was around so long ago. On one hand, it was, and on the other hand, it was just yesterday. Today was my Abraham Lincoln day, and it was lovely. We were right in the middle, in the front. Oh God, it was so good. We were in the sweet spot, you know, we're like in the middle of a theater, in the middle of a row, and it was just. I love Steven Spielberg, how he doesn't exploit anything. He doesn't exploit violence or sexuality or cursing, or he doesn't exploit any of those things. And it just, he was stayed very true. I have my lip gloss. He stayed very true to reality and true to the way of life and true to the story and the characters, and just filtered out all this other excess stuff that could have made the movie more exciting and marketable or whatever. But I mean, it was just, I loved it. I felt like I watched a history book come to life. And for me, that's amazing because I love museums and everything else. I'm kind of a nerd that way. But I think, you know, I don't know, it was just done with a lot of respect. I also got this, which is Altoids, obviously, but I'm going to use it for my business cards and decorate the inside and the outside of the tin. And yeah, I've thought also about my trip. I was gonna go to San Francisco. And as far as touristy type things and living arrangements, I still think San Francisco would be really cool, but now I'm thinking Santa Monica. I still have a lot more research to do. That's why I'm not getting any of my tickets until the end of January, beginning of February, because I want to really take the time to figure out which place would be the best. And I was thinking Santa Monica too, because it's a hop, skip, and a jump to LA. So I could look around Santa Monica and the more residential areas there, and then go out to LA for the more touristy stuff and just to see what the vibe is in both areas. Because San Francisco is quite far removed from LA, and just, I don't want to be in Los Angeles by any means, but I also don't want to be super far away. And I feel like if I'm moving out west to California, I should at least be in, you know, an hour or so away from Los Angeles just because of the nature of what I'm doing, right? That's kind of where I'm leaning towards now is Santa Monica. Also on a fault line. Can't get away from earthquakes, apparently. have you seen Lincoln? Do you plan on seeing Lincoln? Do you share my obsession? Goodbye. Also, please wish me luck, because tomorrow morning I am meeting with the first artist that we are physically approaching for the documentary. She said that we could get together with her and talk about stuff. So wish me luck. Okay.
Do aardvarks even make a sound?